Yo guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to do a video about showcase or what not showcase, just a view of Oni Usopp. Yeah, okay. So my team is not bad. It's SP Nami and Jozu, Big Mom, Sabo and one of Marco. To be honest, I could pull Jozu with special corpus, that's it. This is such a better team. Yeah. Anyways, so we're gonna find those people have SPs and or no SPs. Look at this guy. Yeah, look, I think everybody has SP already. Wow, that's quite fast to be honest. Okay. Right, that's fine. Let's see. These are 4-3-4-4. Okay, that's pretty cool. This one. Let's see a 4-2-4-4 Usopp. Let's see. Wow, weapon. Okay. Speed, clean sets, yeah. Crit combo, yeah. Penetration advancer. Yeah. Pretty good. Interesting, that's really good. Okay, that's a fine. Let's do we have a Uta, right? So make it fair. We do Nami versus, that's fair enough, right? I think. So fine. Right. So this is 4-2-4-4 Usopp. Let's have a see how it goes. Okay. So he's faster than me. 611. Okay, hit it. Okay, missed. So he hits once. 90%. That's quite lucky. Yeah, miss. 90k. Okay, 4.1. Ooh. Yeah, there we go. Silence. Yeah, his T2 is really strong, I think. If he hits it. Okay, he's really squishy. Really squishy. He's really squishy. To be honest, 90% dodge rate is not that insane. Interesting. Okay, miss. Miss again. Okay. 12 million. Let's go, Usopp versus Nami. Who will win? 73. 3.3. 3.2. Yes, T2 is good. The sinus thing. So only able to use skill, and then if he purged it, it can become silence. time on your dreams instead of mine. Yeah, about to turn this franchise around on a dime, man. So I'm wondering what happened to Boogie if you have cleanses as well. It's all about time and the work and the climb from the thirst we will rise. I'm immersed in this. Yeah, his dodge is insane. Okay. Yeah, it's quite interesting. He's quite immunity shield is kind of good. Oh, it hits 90%. Okay. Okay, so basically it's RNG. Okay. Alright, let's skip some battles. See what okay. It's by RNG. Okay, shout out to God Usopp. Player, thank you very much for adding me. Yeah, okay, so let's pull the normal team back on. Let's see if we can fight on it. So it's 2-2-3-4 Usopp. Free to play Usopp. All right, let's see how it goes. No SP Sabo, no Sabo has SP 7 stars. Nice. All right, this is. Okay, let's see. Man. Okay. Interesting. So Usopp, I feel he could be in front position because his 90% dodge is quite really good. However, he's really squishy as you can see. So he can take basically anyone's T1, he will be die. But first 2 turn, he will definitely survive with 90% dodge if you, unless you be not really ridiculously unlucky. But so he should live first 2 turn. And if he killed it again, he will revive and again another 2 turn of dodge rate as well. So I think he can be in front. I don't think his main DPS is DPS though. I think it's more like support. Because I can see his silence is kind of good. And he also his T1 give a shield as well. So he's kind of good for support tank. Yeah. You see, he already silenced two people, Marco and Quarkus, which is kind of good. So you at least can summon two, silence two. Okay. Right. Let's thinking. Well, this game we have, right? I think this dude will be always the fastest one, right? Because his 50 speed can stop off. So on 2-10 needs to give 100 speed in the late, for the equal levels, the 100 speed actually make a whole much difference. Assuming this won't be loose, the 50 stack won't be loose. Even it didn't lose when you awake, you get Sniper King, you get back straight away, 100. So he will be definitely the fastest one. And then I would place him as tank support category. So putting front one, because this dude, right, his silence star is going to be save your so good, right? If he silence Roger, let's say if, example, if he silence Roger, right, that means his T2 turn fight can be locked, right? So basically it's all gone. So basically Roger is half dead, well not half dead, but he won't have the damage for Springfire. Yeah. So he won't release Springfire, which is really good actually. But the downside of this dude is he's so RNG. So the maximum you can get is T1 with a target, T2 with a target, right? Target this. So you send us three, and then you make another target that person. You get one more chance to silence one. So potentially he can silence five character, I think. But it's really rare. But in these days, if I think for meta player, this also will be really good, because silence. But for free to play / the newbie player, I don't think you should go for him. First of all, his DPS 2 RNG and his survivability RNG as well. No worth it to run as well. The highlight of him is definitely the Green Star Impact Wolf, right? Because of silence. You can see when he silenced Marco and Krogus, you can not really still. Basically, you lost T2. Quite a lot of people, like unit that depends on T2, for example, of Zoro. He's T2, right? So if Zoro gets 7 star, that means his T2 cannot pop, right? And then even that, and then so basically if didn't purge it, okay, fine. And then next again, you purge it, you get silence cancel attacks. So you probably will get rid of his revive as well, potentially. We haven't tested it, but I think you might get revive as well if you didn't. If the Zoro didn't purge, so even purge, you still get rid of one of T2, and revive T2 is get rid of his T2 effect, so his first T2 will be useless. Overall, Uso is definitely a good unit, top unit I think as well for meta player, especially with Impact Wolf. And also if putting in the front slots as like use T formation and then pull Usopp in front, that will at least save you 2 turn double kill by front. So if you have some people like Young Rayleigh, Sanji, Lin, then you stop at that, or anyone that Hero Kobe, whatever, so it will definitely save you for his first two. Yeah, overall, I think he is decent. It's really good. When you're placing the tier list below God tier, below, and now Roger and Ace below them. Yeah, and now Roger and Ace still good. Oni Usopp will be so good if his target is target for aiming the highest attack. That would be amazing. However, if you're aiming the highest attack, you won't be only have one target, right? So, given sake, it's fair enough. Because if you have highest attack, that means even with combo, you only can target one person. So, yeah. If he don't, like, basically RNG, right? If he plays really well, Silence Roger and now, boom. There he goes, there's two damage gone. You slowly kill them. And he has revive as well, so he can. This guy can split survive till maybe 10-5, right? Which is 10-5 to 10-6. If you're lucky, that means with support stuff, 10-6. And also, the other thing is the damage block is really good as well. And in conclusion, below guard tier, really depend on RNG. No recommend for free to play, no recommend for newer player. Because on his own, he cannot carry your team. And mainly focus on Snipe King, Snipe God, and Green Star Impact Wolf. Yeah, most importantly, speed and combo. Yeah. So, should you go for it? If you have meta team, like, if you have this team like that, and now, Boggy. And Robin, Marco, and that, you can go for it, right? You can go for it. This actually make your team so good. Wait, is this the Kokomi my layout? Interesting. Anyway, so if you have a team like this, go for it. Definitely, you can replace Weevil. It will actually make so much difference. That means it will be harder to kill your team, and your unit can do damage as well. So if you have a team like this, go for it, definitely. But if you have team like this, I don't think you should. I don't think I should, because I don't have enough damage, and even it gave enough, even when I put in friends for survivability, my other unit cannot do enough damage, which is useless. And his damage is not the best compared to other two, and now and Roger and Ace, so damage wise not good. Yeah, thanks for watching. This is my opinions on it, and if you want to go for it, go for it. It's your favorite character, but I recommend not to go for it now if you can. And now it's much better, so in general. But this guy is RNG based. If you're lucky, really really lucky, holy smoke, you probably have more chance to win it. So let's say if you have 50-50 against someone, if you're getting Usopp, that probably going to boost your chance to 75-25. Yeah, right, think about it. And this is just my opinion. I think you just take advice for it. Listen to law, it's up to you. So yeah, there's another guy, Usopp. See, a character like this, you shouldn't go for it. I think this dude just go for the characters, which is fine. Yeah, but if you want to be meta, just don't go for him if you're like not, don't have enough damage people, damage unit. Yeah, but if you play for fun, just go for the character, I guess. Yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you soon.